Hello, hello. I had so much fun last time painting that asparagus on the board. If you look back, that's my last video. That I have done a similar thing here with the teddy bear. Tied his little paw to a string. I've got a light on him to cast a nice shadow. So we're going to try to do the same thing over here on an 8 by 10 panel. See if we can make him feel dimensional. Yeah, I was trying to think, well, I could do a carrot. There's so many things. Of course, this is obviously much more difficult. But it looks like a fun challenge, doesn't it? So, we'll see how we can do with this. I have turned my overhead light off this time. It's light out. So I think it'll work okay. I fight, different, when I have different light sources, they cast different shadows and it makes it harder. So today, again, I've turned the overhead light off, so our only shadow is the light that's coming from the spotlight that I have on the bear. So I thought that would make it easier. I'm not as ready as I thought I was when I hit record, so bear with me a little bit. Bear with me, ha ha. You get that? BEAR. All right, I mixed up a very dark here, and I'm working with a brush that isn't real small. All right, I'm going to try to do what I did last time with the asparagus and basically try to move this image over here. So, you know, if you follow me, I do a lot of still lives, but doing them like this is different, new for me. I actually really like the asparagus that I did. I considered maybe cutting off that board. I talked about that. It's like a 4x12, and you can get frames that size. I showed it, I took Monday painting to the group that I paint with on Monday some, and was telling them just how much fun that was to set that up right next to you like that and try to reproduce it. And one lady was like, just paint more things. Put a carrot on this side and something else on this side. Oh, you could, I guess. I don't know. I considered a 5x7, but that was a little small. So, I don't know how this will work. We'll see. One thing I did consider too, and I didn't do, was instead of this being on the whiteboard, I considered draping like gray fabric over it. This shadow looks a lot darker than the shadow did from our asparagus. It was surprising how cool and blue it was. We'll just play around a while and try to get the image transferred over. You try something out and think, hey, that was fun. What else? What other ways, might I do that? And oh, the possibilities are endless, don't you think? If you think of some other fun ways to do this kind of thing, let me know of some other objects you think would be fun. And this is kind of a neat setup for you too, isn't it? You can absolutely see what I'm seeing this way. We may have to do major adjustments. We'll see if the drawing's off. And I'm not quite looking at it. I'm to the right of it. I'm off a little different than you are too. Keep that in mind. You know. Main goal is to make it feel three-dimensional, I think. Oh, I can barely see his eyes. If I stand up on my tippy toes, it actually would have been nice to have seen more of his eyes, wouldn't I? And I can see already, I'm gonna have to shift some things up to get my drawing right. You know, maybe I shouldn't have started the way I did with the shadow. Maybe I should have worked my way out to the shadow. Yeah, well. No mistakes, right? And I'm going to be, you know, wiping some of this off too. And we will be painting around him because, you know, I want more of a finished painting this time. See, I should have probably done the bear's body first and then brought the shadow out, but no big deal. You'd have to be really accurate to do it the way I started, I guess. Looking for the darker areas that I see. Like I said, we're going to have to wipe out some of this too. And I, even though his eyes are, I want to be able to see some of the eyes. Okay, let's wipe out some of this. That's actually about where his ear would be. And his hat. So see, I probably should have done the bear first and then worked my way out to the shadow. String, paw. I thought about putting around his neck, but that just didn't seem right. He would have hung better. Strings way up there and goes off. adjust in the drawing some to like get what I want. I used to rush a lot more to get to the painting part of it, but you know, what's the hurry? I'm sure he's moving around a little bit. I pulled him back up a little bit, which I think is a little better. I think I kind of had him that way to start. It don't matter. I hope the light holds out for us and I don't have to turn on the overhead light. It's going to really affect our shadows. All right, I think we'll start. We'll pre-mix up some colors. And I think I'll start with the bear, even though a lot of times I go for the lightest lights, which would be, you know, part of that hat and the bow. Well, this too, of course, is very light. All right, the bear is a warm color. So I'm putting out some transparent red oxide. Putting a little yellow in that. I'm trying to squint and see which is the lightest parts of that bear. Maybe there, probably his face. It's not an object that's got a big variety of values, unfortunately. And we'll do the best we can. working on a dog commission right now and would be doing that right now, but he told me he didn't have to have it till August, so I know I'm got plenty of time. That's why I'm painting teddy bears today, because I can. Just jumping around back and forth. And again, I have to kind of, you probably can't really see his eyes, but I kind of want to see him a little bit. I'm going to mix up some orange just to throw a little orange in some of this too, make it fun. Just met our one grandson came by and we went out and got a bite with them, and they're heading out tomorrow morning for 2 months. They're traveling all over the country, going out west and living in his SUV. That's not for me. I camp, but I say I glamp, you know, I'm glamour camping. Yeah, it's not for me. That's too rugged for me. It's surprising, isn't it? His young girlfriend is willing to do that, but she likes it. They're going to move to Colorado eventually when they get out of college. They're both be juniors next year, but that's where they want to live. The bow's a bit lighter than the hat, but I don't know that it matters to me. I'm using basically the same color. Draw on the ribbons. I may have to adjust some of the color on the body. See how far out, right about even with the hat, is the edge of the bow. And then there's a piece of ribbon that comes out like that. So I say I've got to go around this with the bare color. Okay, let's look at the rose. Go through some paper towels. And the rose is a mauve-y color, as you can see. And it looks more to me like a cooler color, so I'm going to use alizarin rather than cad red light. Those are my only two options. And that's too vibrant, so the complement to red is green. So we're going to put a little green in it. And I'm going after three values, like I always do. Let's look at the darkest part first. Thinking rose here, I'm just going for the shapes and colors that I see. Let me see, am I getting up high enough? No. It's really way up there, isn't it? So let's get it up further. Right, hopefully that, we'll revisit it, but hopefully that feels pretty good. Okay, we're making a green. Put a little red in it. We've got a green leaf up here. Looks like we need to do a little more right here. Stepping back and comparing. And again, I realize you can't really see the eyes, but I feel as though I want them. Actually, that's kind of that teddy bear. It's kind of in the wrong place. It's more over there, that string. All right, let's think about that shadow. Pretty dark. And I'm thinking we may maybe do a gray blue background, maybe. And he's kind of fuzzy, so, you know, with being oil paints, we can pull out some fuzzy stuff. We can do that after we put the background in. Okay. Again, let's think about the background. Move you over a little bit so you can see everything. All right, let's look at these shadow shapes again. Paul goes to about right there. shadow is. It's about there, I think. And I kind of see some shadow under there. See it? Go into some light. We're going to lighten up the same mixture then. And I'm even mixing in some of the teddy bear color into it. We'll see how that goes. Here I am painting on an untoned panel on purpose because, you know, this was a white background, so. So I'm going around different places on the canvas, as you can see, with the color, because I'll be mixing more color. And, you know, I suspect it will be slightly different, so. To decide when I get it covered, like, you know, the end of this ribbon may not show, then we may need to change the value of the background or the ribbon, or maybe neither if it doesn't feel important to me. Ooh, missing that tone, I can tell you. And this is a kind of monochromatic painting because we mix some of the background and the bear color into the background. You know, and we can put a little blue in it. I'm doing that, kind of changing things up now. We'll see what we like. Lighten up some of that string too, so you can see it. Because right now it's kind of lost. just grabbing all kinds of different colors on my palette and mixing them together. Some more white out here. This probably would have been a fun painting to have a toned background. I said this ribbon, I don't know how important it is. I'm just going to cover it over for now. Soften that shadow up some. Just an 8x10. It takes a while to cover it, doesn't it? This is a Centurion linen panel. I don't think I said that. Let's look at Mr. Teddy Bear again now. See what I think he needs. And I do realize that this is a different color than this. I'm aware of that. Now, see, I could put the other end of the ribbon back in, but something, you know, the area around it's going to have to be darker if I do that for it to show. I wish the second part of the ribbon was down here instead of over there. I don't think it's possible. I'm not going to mess with it. hard for you to see too, because it kind of blends in with the whiteboard. Except I get way over here, I can see his eyes, and actually mine are out further. They're kind of cute that way, but his are actually like here. They're very close. I'll think about that. Would that be cuter? It's hard to tell. They're like very close in reality, like there and there. Might be. I said I couldn't really see them, so let's move it over. Could have a little thing there, like teddy bears do, separating his, even though I don't necessarily see it. I'm sorry, bumping ya. When you get over here and look at his eye, he's actually got tiny little reflection, a catch light. Maybe. Some places on this canvas too. It's kind of hard to I was thinking about going a little darker over in this corner. The composition's a little bit different, you know, with him all kind of pulled that to one corner. Well, he's not really, is he? Not too bad. think I might lighten up the rope a little too. All right, I'll look at him now. You know, I was gonna show you, I got him a little more straight. Like I say, he flopped a little bit more than I'd like. And I realize again, his is more brown, mine's warmer. Maybe, it's kind of cute. You know, you could suggest more fur on him if you wanted. I don't know. I'll quit messing with him because I need to look at him. All right, been about an hour. Thanks for joining me. And I don't know. We'll think about what we want to do next time. I've got to get back to my commission too. All right. Thanks again for taking time out of your day. I appreciate it. And like and subscribe if you haven't. Bye-bye.